All right, welcome everybody. We are checking out Wild Wings.
Wild Wings today.
The last episode of
Lord of the Rings.
I forgot the whole name of
the whole thing.
For the last episode of Lord of the Rings, Return of the Kings.
But Return of the Wings! I got the double, he got the double, and we got two flavors each.
So, like, normally it comes with fries or a salad, and I upgraded to the onion rings.
Try the onion rings first?
Because we gotta go Lord of the Rings, right?
They got mad flavors there.
But for Lord of the Rings, we're gonna start it off with the onion rings.
Onion ring. That's a good onion ring.
Mm-hmm. You only like onion rings.
I guess.
Next one, we have their fries. Their fries are... They have like pepper on them.
That's not bad. Simple fry.
That's old school fry.
That's old school fry. I like that. And a bit of pepper. You don't see a lot of pepper on french fries. I like that touch. Classy move, Wild Wing.
I like the fact put it on top so you don't have to, like, you know,
do it yourself.
Guesstimate.
It's the garlic parmesan and honey garlic.
Mmm. Sammy's are not breaded and mine are breaded.
Yeah, Brian's are breaded. Cheers.
Cheers.
Wow, that's savory.
That's different.
That's a lot of flavor. It was, like, very creamy. It's got to be the parmesan.
Mmm. For me, I'm not used to it. I'm like...
That's a lot for you.
It's a lot for me.
It's not bad.
Not bad.
It's not my favorite.
Very different flavor to it.
Yeah. I like honey garlic, so mm-hmm. I think I went with that for this. And trying something different. I'll try to always switch it up a little bit and try something different.
This one, I can tell, I'm probably going to like this one.
Cheers.
Cheers. It's not very strong with the ketchup flavor, but...
No. I would have asked for double flavor next time.
Mm-hmm.
Especially on a trip like this. This, I feel like, is a good chip to watch a movie with because it's got the dry sauce and it's like a chip.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a wing, right? So this would be a good movie wing. I would want more wings, though. That's something that I'm going to say right off the bat. Mm-hmm. Just like...
It comes with eight.
In the double, to come with like eight wings of each flavor, like, I want at least 10.
Says this now.
Yeah.
He says... So now we have the medium. These look big because of the extra batter on top of it, eh?
Yeah. Wow.
Mm.
They are juicier with the extra batter.
Mm-hmm. But it's a sour spice to it, so take that into account.
Oh my god, it does have a bit of a sour taste. Mm-hmm. It's not crazy hot, so it's medium, right?
Yeah, it's medium.
It's a good medium.
I would say this is like similar to like a French kind of thing.
It tastes like a Frank's hot sauce.
Mm-hmm. And then this is the Daisy Duke.
It's crazy how saucy yours are.
It's because they're like the wetter ones. You have
the dry rub, right?
More.
I would ask for double flavor next time.
Yeah, that one for sure. If you got double flavor for that, it that would be like
sick.
So good.
It would be so good. Yeah.
Cheers.
It's like a smoky flavor.
Mm-hmm. You really taste the smoky barbecue flavor to it.
Oh my god, you really do.
I actually kind of prefer this one over the medium.
I do too.
Mm.
I like that there's a lot more body to the flavor.
Oh yeah.
These, like with the bread, the wings look more full in the box, and it does fill me up more.
Yeah, it does actually.
The like breaded ones, like if you were to get eight, if you were to finish two, that's not bad.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder if they add more flavor if it's breaded or not.
Mm.
You know what I mean?
True.
I would want double the flavor on that ketchup and then it would be perfect. The standout one for me, is the Daisy Duke, for sure. I would definitely go the road that you did with like a very saucy flavor like this to get the breaded because I think it soaks in the flavor more.
Yeah. You might be right about that.
You know what I'm saying? Because like I'm looking at this one and this is a saucy one and it's good, but with the bread, I think it would be
absorbs.
Better.
Yeah.
The ketchup chip one is one of my favorites.
Yeah.
It's got awesome flavor. Usually, like I've had it in the past where they had more dry rub on it.
Yeah.
You know, the restaurants are just back to normal. It could just be, you know, getting used to things again. Yeah. I would want double the flavor on this, but that's a sick, sick wing.
Yeah,
so if I was to go back, I would do as a dry one because I tried to always get a dry and then a savory one. I would get this for sauce and that one for dry.
Same thing for me. I would pick that one and this one as well. I think that they have like a lot of selection there. There's like probably around like 101 different like flavors over there. And they don't only do wings, they do other dishes as well, but if you're going to Wild Wings, if you're going to Wild Wings, you're going to go for wings, right?
Yeah.
So be careful of going on very busy days like the Super Bowl and stuff like that. Because they can get overwhelmed with a lot of stuff. Because of all the selections that they have, people will tend to take longer to decide which wings that they want to get. Slows down the staff a lot.
They had other chip flavor wings. I would be really interested in trying some of those wings. Mm-hmm. Like the salt and pepper, what's that about? You know, like what other flavors do they have in that realm? Because that's awesome.
Yeah. Right, so we say check it out. Check out the different flavors that over there at Wild Wings. And on to the movie. Oh, the story finally ends. We've got to finish the last episode of Lord of the Rings, The Return of the King, and there are a lot of updates to this movie.
Certain moments when in the theatrical version, and I think you mentioned it too while we were watching, we were like, oh, that didn't make sense to me before, but now it does. That's a good word.
For example, the ghosts. The ghost army.
The honoring of that, like, you know, oath.
Like the original one, when we watched it, it was like they came out of nowhere off the ship and it didn't make sense, right?
I remember thinking that too. I'm like, where did the boat come from? But then you kind of like, whatever, it's a boat.
But they have a lot more scenes that kind of make sense to this whole thing. And they have like more impact in this movie than that one battle, right?
They could have made this trilogy 4 movies.
They kind of continued on with some of the extra scenes that had happened in previous Lord of the Rings. Yeah. And that's the reason why some of these shots were eliminated, because they only made sense because of the extended scenes from previous movies.
Totally. You could see the like domino effect of that.
Right? Yeah,
like there was... You take out this one, then you got to take out this one and the next one and then that one and the next
one.
Too,
Yeah. So, and then there were the odd few... cuts that were kind of like
campy and cheesy.
Too campy and too cheesy. I also kind of forgot how like melodramatic this movie is. Everybody's crying. Everybody's crying. They're so over the top where they like, he's so upset that he's dropping the book. And it's just like,
Why?
At the time, when I first watched it, it was like, it was revolutionary.
Groundbreaking.
But now there's certain things where I'm like,
it's been done.
It's kind of cheesy.
This is 20 years old now.
But that's not to say that I didn't enjoy it. This one of all the movies is the most epic of all of them.
I think I like the second one the most.
Really?
Now.
Oh, they all have their pros and cons.
The second one has some pretty cool battles.
The second one compared to this one?
I don't know. There are some pretty sick battles in both.
I think
and
this
the
one
overall
had...
story of the second one I liked.
I thought the battles in this one were like way more epic than the second one. And I love the fact that Samwise is like
the G.
Like the biggest impact in this movie than any other movie.
Everyone's like, Frodo, you did it. Like, no, man. Like, no. All right, listen. If Frodo wasn't there, sure, the ring wouldn't be there.
Yeah.
But if Sam wasn't there, the ring wouldn't get to where it needed to go.
So
that's all I'm saying.
It goes into different stages of how badass Sam is. In the first movie, he literally almost drowns to get to Frodo. Second movie, he's showing some like real loyalty when he's like helping him out.
Him kick off the freaking quest.
The journey. And then the third one, he's literally fireman carrying Frodo up the mountain.
While trying to swap Gollum off his back, just juked a
killing orcs and everything. Oh my gosh. This guy could have did the whole thing by himself. Yeah. There's one big problem in this movie that logistically didn't make sense to me was the fact that it opens up with Sméagol and his friend, like when they're actual hobbits. And how the ring immediately took control over them when in the very first Fellowship of the Ring, they were talking about how hobbits have a restraint from the ring. But yet these guys, the instant that they like had the object in their hand, they were like, they were all fighting for it like humans would have been. So I was like, that kind of doesn't make sense, that whole logic thing. But that was the only thing that was kind of like, for me, that was like the thing I was like, what the hell is this?
Peter Jackson, if you're watching this YouTube video, could you just give us a ring and tell us your thoughts or just, you know, smash the like button and just, you know, write a comment down below for our...
If somebody out there knows this, the reason for that, please comment below because I'm curious.
Yeah, why did Sméagol get attached to the ring
immediately
so fast and like, you know, and his friend who they don't name? Hobbit number two.
Hobbit number two.
As opposed to when Frodo took it.
Or even when Bilbo took it.
Even when Sam wanted to take it.
Yeah, and even Bilbo.
Why didn't Sam want the ring the same way Frodo and Smeagol did?
He did, kind of, but like not to the extent that...
Did he, though?
Yeah. And we gotta say that Sam's got this huge loyalty to Frodo, that he's that loyal that here you go.
He's bringing that real Hobbit energy.
Also, can you guys explain to me how come Sam only says Mr. Frodo to Frodo and nobody else?
And what's with the pots and pans? They've been carrying around pots and pans for months.
Only Sam's been carrying pots and
pans. Sam's carrying around pots and pans for months. All they're eating is dry ass bread. Why, man?
It doesn't make sense.
Even in Mordor, he's like, let me change costume here. Let me put my belt back on.
He got the orc armor, but yet he keeps the pots and pans in his armor and he's going after Mordor. It was too funny. We were like, are those pots and pans?
There's literally like no food in Mordor to eat besides like...
I know, they literally had nothing.
And he's like, just in case we find a rabbit. Like, where, bro? Where's the rabbit?
It doesn't make sense.
Anyways. Peter Jackson, if you're watching this YouTube video, can you tell us about pots and pans? Thank you, bro.
Anyways, we really enjoyed it. We highly suggest checking out Lord of the Rings, especially the theatrical edition
see the theatrical. If you have watched them and you want to do something a little different,
yeah,
the extended versions are pretty sick.
Yeah.
And, you know, they do give you an intermission for flipping the discs. If you remember old VHS, where you had to pop the second one in.
Yeah.
So you're looking at about 2 hours per disc. But you know what? Grab your favorite snack and your best bud. And watch it.
Exactly. And that does it for the Lord of the Ring edition, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye.
Peace.